Hello everyone, today's topic is splay tree. So splay tree is one of the type of search tree. It is a self-adjusting BST, that is the binary search tree. Self-adjusting, we don't have to do the any adjustment. Rotations are there to perform the adjustments. So it is a roughly balanced tree. It is not a strictly balanced tree. Strictly balanced tree is the AVL tree. So we do not have to balance it very strictly. It is a roughly balanced tree. So one more important thing is that in the splay tree, that is the splaying property. So what the splaying property says, operation on every element will take the, it will rearrange the place of the element and it will get the position of root. So the operation on every element will means what we have to do. Splaying is, suppose I want to perform any operation on 7. So operation on 7 I have to perform, that operation I will perform, but the 7 will take the position of root only. So now there are some rotations in the splay tree, we will see discuss one by one. So first is the zig rotation. So here zig rotation, and I will perform the search operation here. So search 7 here. So BST rule I have to apply here. So 7, I have to search 7 first. So 7 is less than root, that is 10. So 7 is less than root, so it will appear in the left subtree of the root. So 7, find out the position of 7, so I will get the position of 7 here. So I got the position of here 7. So the searching operation is completed, but the splaying operation remains. So splaying property I have to apply here. So first, find out the position of root. The root is the right of 7. So perform the right operation, that is the zig operation. We can call it as a right operation also. Zig is also called as a right rotation. Okay. So 7 is the root here now. 7 is the root. So what is the left and right subtree of the 7? So left of the 7 will be the automatically 1. Now, right of the 7 is 10 because it will go to the right of the 7. Then the right of the 10 is 20 and right of the 20 is 30. But find out the position of 9. So 9 is the left right of 7, but the left of 10. 9 is right of 7 and left of 10. So 9 is right of 7 and left of 10. So here is the position of 9. So this is the zig rotation, that is the right rotation. Now next is the zag rotation. So we can call it as a left rotation also. Left rotation. So search 20 here. So I want to search the 20. So find out the position of 20. So again compare with the root. 10 is greater than 20 is greater than 10. So it will appear in the right subtree of the 10. So here is the position of 20. I got the 20. So searching operation completed. Fine. Now we have to perform the splaying. So how we will apply the splaying here? So 20 is the right of the root. So I have to rotate that to the leftward. So left operation I have to perform. So 20 will be the root here. So left of 20 will be 10. Left of 20 will be 10 because 10 will go to the left of 20. Then left of 10 is 7. Then left subtree will be as it is, that is 1 and 9. And the right of 20 will be 30. So this is the zig rotation. How to perform the zig rotation I have discussed here. So next is the zigzag rotation. So zigzag rotation, while performing the zigzag rotation, zig means right. So right rotation, right rotation. Okay, so while performing this rotation, if I have to remember that the suppose I want to search here 1. So 1 should have the parent as well as the grandparent. So 1 should have the parent as well as the grandparent. So search 1 here. So find out the position of 1. 1 is less than root, so it will appear in the left subtree. 1 is also less than 7, so I got the position of 1 here. So in the zigzag rotation, what happens whenever you are performing the zigzag rotation, there the element should have parent as well as the grandparent. So first operation should perform on the grandparent. So there are two right rotation will be performed here. So first right rotation will be performed on the grandparent. So the tree will look like, first zig operation I will perform here. So the tree will look like here. 7 will be the root. 10 will go to the right of the root. And 9 is the left of 10 as it is. And 15 will go to the here. 13. 20 and 30. Okay, so and left of 7 is 1 and left of 1 is minus 1. Now second zig operation I have to perform. Second zig operation here. So tree will be look like 1 will be the root here. So I will draw here tree. 1 will be the root and the right of 1 will be 7. Left of 1 will be minus 1. Now see. So right of 7 will be according to this. We will see according to this. So right of 7 will be 10. Left of 10 will be 9. And the right of 10 will be 15. Left of 15 is 13. Right of 15 is 20. And right of 20 is 30. So this is the zigzag operation. Next is the zigzag operation. So zigzag operation means left and left operation. Left operation. Zag means left. So I have to perform search here 20. So find out the position of 20. So here 15 is the right of the 10 and the 20 is the right of 15. So 20 has the parent 15 and the grandparent 10. So no issue, I can perform this zigzag rotation because two left rotation I have to take. So first left rotation will perform on the grandparent. So grandparent first. So 15 will be root here. 10 will go to the left of the 15. Again 7 will go to the left of 10. 9 will go to the right of 7. 1 is left of. Okay. And the remaining tree, right subtree will be 20. Then 30. Now the find out the position of 13 here. So 13, position of 13 will be left of 15 but right of 10. Left of 15 means left subtree, it will be in the left subtree and the right of 10. So this is the first zag operation. Next zag operation is, I will draw the tree here. So next zag operation, I have to rotate this 20 here. So 20 will be the root now. So 15 will be the left of 20 and 30 is the right of 20. Now this tree will draw as it is, that 10 is the left of 15, 13 is the right of 10, then 7 is the left of 10, then 1 is the left of 7, 9 is the right of 7 and minus 1 is the left of 1. So next two operations. So next operation is zigzag operation, that is right left operation. Okay, zig means right, zag means left. So I have to perform zigzag rotation here. So search 13. Find out the position of 13. 10 is the root here. So 13 is greater than 10. It will go to the right of the 10. So 15 is here. So again search is here. So 13, I got the position of 13. So search operation has get completed. Now what happened? I have grandparent as well as the parent and grandparent. So in the previous rotations, we have performed operations zigzag and zigzag rotation. So in that case, first we will performing operation on grandparent. Now we have to perform operation on parent first and then grandparent. So the tree will look like first zig operation. So where is the zig operation? Zig means right rotation. So here the right rotation will be performed. So the root is 10 here. The left of 10 is 7. The left subtree will be as it is. And the zig operation I will perform here. So what will happen? 13 will go up. 15 will come down. So the left of 15. Left of 13 is 11. Left of 13 is 11. But the 14 is here also. So again I have to perform 20 here. Okay. So find out the position of 14. 14 is the right of 13. 14 is the right of 13 but left of 15. Left of 15. 14 is here. Okay. So first zag operation has completed. So I got the position of 15 here, 13 here. So now again perform the zag rotation. Which rotation? Zag rotation. That is the left rotation I have to perform. So I will draw T here. So 13 will be root. So the 10 will go to the left of root. So again 10, 7 is as it is. 1 and 9 is also as it is. So left subtree will be look like. And now write down the, I will draw the right subtree. So 13 is the root now. So 15 will be the, okay, 15 will be the right child of 13. Then 15 having two children, that is 14 and 20 that I will draw as it is. Now the problem is 11. So for find out the position for 11, 11 is the left child of 13. 11 is the left child of 13 and the right child of 10. So I will got here the position of 11. Okay. So this is the zigzag rotation. Now last rotation is the zigzag rotation, that is left right rotation. Left right rotation. So I have to search here 9. So find out the position of 9 first. So position of 9 is less than 10, so it will appear in the left subtree. Again I have got one element here, that is 7. So 9 is greater than 7. So first operation is left operation. Means which operation I have to perform here? So first zig operation, that is I have to perform on the parent only. So what will happen? So tree will be first zag rotation, that is left operation. So 15 as it is, right subtree will be as it is, that is 13 and 20. Okay, so the left subtree will be look like 9 will go to the up position. So left of 9 is 8, left of 9 is 8, but the 10 having the 7 is also a left of 10. So what I have to do, first I will draw here 7. So next element is 1. 1 is the left of 7. Now find out the position for 8. 8 is a left of 9. Left of 9 but right of 7. So the position of 8 will be here. Now the next operation I have to perform here, zig operation. So zig on which? So zig operation I have to perform here only. So I will draw tree here. 9 will be the root now. So the right of the 9 is 10. Right of the 9 is 10. So 10 having the right children 15 and the 13 10. Okay. So left of the 9 is 7 and 1 and then 8. So this is all about the rotations in splay tree. So this is all about the splay tree. And if you have any doubt regarding the splay tree or how to perform the rotations in splay tree, you can comment in the comments box. And thank you for watching my video.